Hello everyone, today I'm going to teach you English grammar chapter number 4, that is noun. If you like this video, then do this video a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon so that you can get all my videos notification and share this video with your family and friends too. So let's get started. First of all, I would like to tell you the content of the chapter. What is noun? Example of noun. Kind of noun with definition. Examples of kind of noun. What is countable and uncountable noun? Example of countable and uncountable noun. And we will be looking around the solved exercise of noun. So let's get started. What is noun? What do you mean by noun? Noun refers to the name of person, place, animal, material, thing, and even emotion or idea. This means noun denotes to the name of person, place, animal, material, thing, and even emotion or idea. Let's have the look on the example of noun. Abhinav. Abhinav is a noun. Why Abhinav is a noun? Abhinav is a noun because Abhinav is a name of a person. Mumbai. Mumbai is a noun. Why Mumbai is a noun? Mumbai is a noun because Mumbai is a name of a place. Rabbit. Rabbit is a noun. Why rabbit is a noun? Rabbit is a noun because rabbit is a name of an animal. Book. Book is a noun. Why book is a noun? Book is a noun because book is a name of thing. Brick. Brick is a noun. Why brick is a noun? Brick is a noun because brick is a name of material. Love. Love is a noun. Why love is a noun? Love is a noun because love shows us emotion and feelings. Now, moving towards the another slide, that is kind of noun. There are five kind of noun: common noun, proper noun, collective noun, abstract noun, and material noun. What do you mean by common noun? Common noun refers to the common name of person, place, animal, or thing. This means common noun denotes to the common name of person, place, animal, or thing. We can also say that common noun does not talk about the particular person, particular place, particular animal, or particular thing. Let's have the look on the examples of common noun. Man, woman, tiger, tree, river, hill, table, children, school, teacher, birds, doctors, chocolates, cakes, and markers. These all are considered as the common noun. Children love sweets. Children and sweets are the common noun. I am going to school. School is a common noun. Teachers teach in school. Teachers and school is a common noun. Birds live on trees. Trees and birds are the common noun. I love to read storybooks. Storybooks is a common noun. Sally's mother is a doctor. Doctor is a common noun. These chocolates and cakes are so delicious. Chocolates and cakes are the common noun. Now moving towards the another slide, that is proper noun. What do you mean by proper noun? Proper noun is a name of particular person, place, animal, or thing. This means proper noun denotes to the name of particular person, place, animal, or thing. Proper noun always begins with capital letter. Now let's have the look on the examples of proper noun. James, Mumbai. December, Sachin, Dev, Tom, Jenny, Sony, Goa. These all are considered as the proper noun. Tom likes toy. Tom is a proper noun. Jenny is a good girl. So Jenny is a proper noun. Sony produces camera too. Sony is a proper noun. Goa is known for fantastic beaches. So, Goa is the proper noun. Let us understand common noun and proper noun with more examples. Dev, Harish, Rohan. In this, Dev, Harish and Rohan are the specific name of a particular person or a particular boy. So what is common in them? Boy. So boy is a common noun. Okay. India, South Africa, Brazil. India is a specific country. South Africa is a specific country and Brazil is a specific country. So what is common in them? Country. So country is a common noun. Red, blue, black. They are the specific name of a specific color. So what is common in them? Color is common in them. Now moving towards the another slide, collective noun. Collective noun refers to the name of group of people, animal or thing forming a unit. Collective noun denotes to the group of people, animal or thing forming a unit. Let's have the look on the example of collective noun. Crowd, bunch, flock, pack. These all are considered as the collective noun. For example, I have 2-3 keys with me. So what will I call the group of keys? I will call them a bunch of keys. For example, I saw too many loins in front of them, a group of loins. We can say that. Then what will I call that group? A pride of loin. Most of the people get confused which word to be used for a group of people. Let's have the look on collective noun used for the group of people. Okay? A group of people watching a match. Spectator. A group of people gathered without particular purpose. Crowd. A group of people gathered for some destructive purpose. Mob. A group of people at religious meeting. Congregation. A group of people listening to lecture. Audience. Now moving towards the abstract noun. An abstract noun is the name of quality, idea, feeling, or a thing which cannot be touched or seen. Okay? The noun which denotes the quality, idea, feeling which cannot be touched but can be felt is known as abstract noun. Let's have the look on the examples of abstract noun. Beauty, wisdom, childhood, thickness, truth, gossip, fear, idea, strength. They all are abstract noun because we cannot touch them but we can feel them. Okay? It is not true that a judge always gives right justice. Justice is a abstract noun. India got freedom from British rule in 1947. So freedom is an abstract noun. Every year, 15th of August, a bravery award is given to Indian people by the Prime Minister. So bravery is an abstract noun. Love is an uncontrollable desire. So desire is an abstract noun. Now moving towards the material noun. Material noun is a name used as an ingredients for making things. Let's have the look on the examples of material noun. Brick, wood, gold. Brick is used for making house. Wood is used for making furniture. And gold is used for making ornaments. What do you mean by countable noun? Noun that can be counted are called countable noun. Let's have the look on the examples of countable noun. Book, pen, egg, house. These are considered as the countable noun as they can be counted. Rohan has two bags. Bags is a countable noun because we can count them. I have 5 pencils. Pencil is a countable noun because we can count the pencils. Okay. What do you mean by uncountable noun? Uncountable noun that cannot be counted are called uncountable noun. Milk, air, water, tea, ink. These all are considered as the uncountable noun as we cannot count them. I like to eat sugar. Sugar is an uncountable noun. He has a little milk. Milk is an uncountable noun as we cannot count milk. Now moving towards the solved exercise of noun. Take the correct option. The book was lying on the table. Book is a common noun. Book is a proper noun. Or book is a collective noun. The right answer is book is a common noun. Love begets love. Love is a common noun. Love is a collective noun. Or love is a abstract noun. Love is a abstract noun. The jury has given the verdict. Jury is a common noun. Jury is a collective noun. Jury is an abstract noun. Jury is an collective noun. Alcohol is injurious to health. Health is a common noun. Health is an abstract noun. Health is a proper noun. Health is an abstract noun. Smoking is a bad habit. Habit is a common noun. Habit is an abstract noun. Habit is a proper noun. Habit is an abstract noun. All the girls were singing. Girls is a common noun. Girls is a proper noun. Girls is an abstract noun. Girls is a common noun. Decide whether these nouns are countable or uncountable. The children are playing in the garden. Countable. I don't like milk. Milk is uncountable. I prefer tea. Tea is uncountable noun. My mother uses butter to prepare cakes. Uncountable noun. There are lot of windows in our classroom. Windows is an uncountable noun. Window is a countable noun. We need some glue to fix this vase. Glue is an uncountable noun. The waiters in this restaurant are very professional. Countable noun. My father drinks 2 big glasses of water every morning. So glasses is a countable noun. Thank you for watching my video. Like, share, comment and subscribe.